Anybody excited yet?
Yeah.
You know, we've had a lot of people leave here over the years and go on to bigger and better things and for different reasons have left. And we had a family left us probably 25 years ago, at least one of them. And they didn't go very far. They just went to Summersville. Very, very, very good. Very good family, community oriented. Kind, cheerful, and nice. My wife and man I'm introduced to you here, his sister, graduated from high school together, and they're best friends to this day. And I won't tell you how many years ago that's been. But anyhow, just to show you, I can make it brief. Steve Ferguson is back in Richwood tonight. He's working on this project for the Boy Scouts at CCC. And I tell you what, they couldn't have picked, or a better person couldn't have stepped up and volunteered his service to this project than Steve Ferguson. He's been successful at what he's done along with his family effort. And I congratulate and Steve and his family on what they have done. Anyhow, Steve, would you come forward and tell us about the fundraising portion of this, please?
Thanks, John. It's good to be back in Richwood. Class of 1974. You can do the math. I usually don't take notes. My good friend Robert Schaefer said, Steve, just tear the notes up. You do better just speaking. But this is so important. I want to make sure that I go through and hit what I'm supposed to let you all know about. Because this is really the nuts and the bolts of what we as communities have to do to take advantage of this great opportunity. First of all, Steve Van Lyon is a good friend of mine. He's actually the champion of Nicholas County. He would have been here tonight. He was on the board and actually good friends with Milam Mike Puskar, who was such a friend to the university, and he passed away last week, and Steve's actually at his services, or he would have been here if it hadn't been those circumstances. And he asked me to kind of fill in, and I told him I would be glad to do that. Let me tell you what I don't know first. I don't know the number of the projects that's going to happen. I don't know the location of the projects that's going to happen. I don't know the economic impact of the selected projects. I don't know the personal cost versus the benefit of these projects. And what I mean by that is there is some cost to the community. There's time. There's going to be fundraising. There's going to be money. And I don't know if that cost is going to translate into the benefit that we'll get. I don't know the integral process that they're going to go through to select these projects. They do have a process, and I'm impressed with the Boy Scouts, the CCC, of how they're going to go through and actually screen these projects for acceptance. Now that's what I don't know. But let me tell you a little bit about what I do know. Nicholas County is one of nine counties that they feel and they have targeted around this National Scout Jamboree, the National Scout Reserve, that they think it's going to have a large impact. And they said they've identified that. The second thing I know, there's 40,000 scouts coming whether we're ready or not. They're coming in 2013. Of those scouts, scouts leaders, that's what they're advertising. There's a lot of them that won't come, and that's over a two-week period. There's a lot of them that, my understanding, that won't come. Their families may bring them. Maybe it's just not like they're going to come in and drop them off. A lot of times their families travel with them, and they don't go to the Jamboree. They're going to be in our communities. They're going to do 300,000 community service hours. That was probably about the number of hours that was spent on the forward console job last year. That's a lot of hours. 33,333 hours of those scouts are going to be right here in Nicholas County. We do have a great champion, because he's a good friend and partner of mine, If we've got the right people involved, we're going to get our share. We've got a good champion to see that. In fact, I think most of the people that's involved with this will tell you that Nicholas County is ahead of the curve in the nine counties. They've chosen us to do some pilot projects. We'll talk about that in a little bit. The community service is going to be done over 5 days. They're here for 2 weeks. There's a five-day window when they're going to do this community service. 8,000 scouts per day are going to be in these nine county areas. That means that almost 900 scouts a day are going to be in Nicholas County for those 5 days. The selection process. We need good projects. This is where you come in. We need to identify them. We need to get a project application filled out, whether it's you as an individual, whether it's you as a city group, whether it's you as a church. Anybody can fill them out, but we need projects, and toward the end, I'll talk about that a little bit more. The selection process, what the scouts want to do, they want to look for projects that are green friendly. They like construction projects. They like infrastructure projects. They like wellness projects. And they like arts and education projects. They don't really want to come in here and pick up a litter. It's not what they want to do. They want to come in and do something where they can come back down the road or bring their family and say, hey, I was a part of that. I was a part of this renovation of Camp Splinter. I was a part of building this park, this garden area. God bless her soul. I wish, and Mrs. Corbett will understand this. I wish Lola Lust was here, my grandmother. She took a god pile in Milltown and built a garden, a flower garden. That's the type of projects they want. Okay, what I've heard, and you've heard too, $400 million in phase one for 1,200 to 2,000 acres, 10,000 acre project. They are talking about when this thing's finished, it will be a $1 billion investment. Guys, I don't have to be the best accountant, the best CPA, or the best business. There's going to be opportunities here. I don't know what they are. Can't see them. You may not be able to touch them, you may not be able to fill them, but there's an opportunity here, and shame on us if we let it go by. As I said before, we need volunteers. The unique thing about this project is it's 2013. You say, 2013? How long will that wait? How are we going to get ready? Well, we've got a lot to do to get ready, and we're going to talk about getting our county ready. We're going to talk about our projects. Our deadline is March, unless they've extended. It's March 31. We need to have our projects in. So that's our first stage, is identifying potential projects. Now, Steve Amerine and I talked about this, and we talked about it with some other leaders. I see this more just the Boy Scouts, and I know I'm just supposed to be here and talk about the Boy Scout project. If your project gets submitted, but it doesn't get approved that they're going to do it, we are forming a database of projects that need to be done in this county. And so what we can do, if we think out of the box big enough, number one, maybe it doesn't get selected this time around. Maybe it gets selected next time around. Maybe it's not have to be the Boy Scouts that do it. We now have a database. Maybe we go to the local church, or we go to a local Rotary, or we go to a local business and say, would you adopt this project? This was a good project. The Boy Scouts just couldn't fit it in. It still wasn't a good project. Great project. Just didn't fit for what they wanted to do. We'll take that. We now have a database of all these projects, and we'll try to hand it off to some civic leaders or whatever, see if we can get it done. It's teaching us how. My big comment on the whole thing was this. The Boy Scouts are smart. Man, I should have been a scout. Well, I wasn't a scout. I just didn't go very far. But they're smart because you know what they're really doing here? It's not the hours you're going to get, the volunteer hours you're going to get from them. They're going to teach us how to do community service. We as adults are going to have to prepare. We're going to spend a lot more time in preparation for them than they are actually during that day. But what a great concept. What a great concept. They're going to come in here, and just like Robert said, we've got to be ready. We've got to have supplies on hand. We've got to have adult leaders. If we're building a house, we need construction people. So there's a lot of different ways that you're going to volunteer for this project. There's a lot of different ways to use your talent. My brother is the one that got all the talent as far as construction. I have none. Zero. I'm not really good at a lot of things. But I'm being used because I can sell a little bit, I can organize a little bit, and I can spread the message. Your job, even though it's a small group, is fine. Go out and tell 10 other people. And tell 10 other people. Because this thing is a large process. So here's what you do. You stay after this formal meeting. This meeting doesn't end when the last speaker gets up. We have booth setups and tables set up for different. For example, I'm going to be the chair of the fundraising committee. I'll be at that table. If you're interested in participating in the fundraising part of a project, say, hey, Steve, I can't do a lot, but I'll help you any way I can. You know, what I envision is, you got a project, you identified it, it's approved, we're going to go up there and do it here in Richwood. We're going to fix the grants event. We need supplies, we need paint, we need whatever that is. Then it'll be our job to go raise monies, raise supplies, to be able to fund that so when the Boy Scouts come in, they don't ever miss. Get the grant, supplies, leadership, go. The Boy Scouts themselves, though, are going to fund some of these projects. Not fund directly, but either through the CCC or whatever, there are some grants or something that's going to be available to go into each of the 9 counties. And again, we have a great champion in Steve Amline. We will get our fair share. So it's not all going to have to be right out of the community. The most important one I want you to go to, though, even though they're all very important, is applications and nominations. Find out. Pick up a packet. Find out how you fill it out. Find out how you identify. It'll tell you in there those key points. Wellness, construction, you know, the ones that are green friendly, of what they're really looking for and what they would like to do. So after this is over, please go to these stations. Please talk to the people there. Please sign up. Even if down the road you're not sure, go ahead and sign up. Give us the contact information. We'll contact you. You can ask more about it then, or you can decide a little bit later, because again, this is over 2 years. Now, a couple exciting things. I said we were a little bit ahead of the curve. I'm excited. First thing we're going to do is we're going to get into the schools. That was what they mandated me to do tonight, try to see if I can get our superintendent to do a presentation to get our young people involved. Get good ideas from them. Teach them about community service. The second thing that we're going to do is we're going to apply, and hopefully we will be accepted for a pilot project next year, 2012, not 2013. Now, the pilot project may not have the scouts involved. It may be the CC and their volunteers coming in so that we can trial run and figure how this is going to go. They're going to take the buses right from the site so that, you know, we just mimic everything. So we see how long it gets to get here to Richwood. How long are they going to be on the bus and how much work that they can actually do? So we've got some challenges ahead. We can do this. And guys, I'll leave you with this. I'm going to go back and tell you what I don't know. I don't know. I don't know if this is going to be a great thing. I don't know how much work it's going to take on us. I don't know what the scouts really have in mind. But I got a gut. And my gut tells me this is going to be good for your community. It's going to be good for our county. It's going to be good for our economics. And besides all that, it's going to be good to feel good about yourself when you do community service. If nothing else, you're going to get that out of it. And when you do things for other people and stuff, and I learned that from my parents and my grandparents, that's what you're supposed to do. That's your social responsibility. And they've got it in a format that we can fulfill that responsibility. So I hope you're really considering to get involved. There's a lot of ways to get involved. And I thank you for your time, and it's good to be back in Richwood. Thank you.